Hi everybody, I'm Tom Tierney, the director of the Sony Music Archives, and seeing as how Janis Joplin is our legacy artist of the month, we thought we'd have a walk through the Sony Music Archives today and have a look at some of our cool Janis-related stuff. First of all, a little documentation. We have these documents here, we call them artist contract cards. They're not contracts, but they just indicate recording dates, release dates, take information, and other information that our researchers use to put historical information on whatever projects we're using. So this document here is what we would use to find the recording date for Peace of My Heart, which was Janis's recording with Big Brother and the Holding Company, her first band and the first release on Columbia. March 20th, 1968 was the recording date, and this is one of our master cards. We have a card like this for every master in Columbia Records, and again, gives all the information that we have for this particular recording, Peace of My Heart, probably her most famous recording. All that little stuff on there has information of great significance in it to researchers of significance. Some more cool old documents, a nice old biography of Janis from 1968. As we move along into some of our other stuff here, these materials in this binder here, they're what we call slicks. Now, slicks were used in the old LP days as a way of distributing album art, and basically it's album covers printed on nice glossy paper, and we are really lucky here in the Sony Music Library that we have these binders full of all original album slicks from the 60s and 70s. The reason they're so very helpful to us is that we have reissue projects that require mint versions of album covers so that when the cover shows up on a CD cover or in some type of promotional art, that we have materials that are perfect and without the type of ring wear and sort of edges that come along when you have albums that have been around for, 45 years now. So this is our original copy of I Got Them Old Cosmic Blues Mama from 1969, but when we do a reissue, we use these. So that's our perfect mint copy of the cover. Some other nice things that we have, we're very lucky that we have a really great file system for print ads, again from the 1960s and 70s for the Columbia and Epic Records labels. This ad, again going back to Peace of My Heart and Big Brother and the Holding Company, this was a really nice ad from 1968, it's from Cashbox, from August 24th, 1968. Oh, this is Doors. Now, in our photo library here, where we keep all of our negatives, all of our chromes, colors, and black and whites for all of the artists who have ever recorded for Sony Music labels, we have this. So we have contact sheets for all of our negatives, and this here is the contact sheet with the negative that was used for that particular image. Again, from March 1968, right after Big Brother got signed to Columbia. There's a nice contact sheet just of Janis from the same photo shoot, 1968, right around the time that the recordings happened, about 2 or 3 months before Cheap Thrills was actually released in June or July of 68. One more print ad that I wanted to show you is this one, which was published about a week, obviously, after Janis died in October of 1970. We at Columbia mourn the death of a great lady, so we've got this in our files to sort of remember Janis by, alongside everything else we've got. And kind of a down note to end our walk through the archives on, but there you are. Again, I'm Tom Tierney with the Sony Music Archives. Thanks for walking through the library with me, and I'll see you next time on LegacyRecordings.com.